Hi everyone and welcome back, it's Vicky here with another art journal project. As promised, I will be sharing more holiday themed art journal projects. Here is one I made about a week ago. You can always use a punch on one side and then put it back on your disc bound journal if you like. But I'm planning to frame these ones and decorate my house for the holidays, so I'm not going to punch them just yet. So for today I will be working on 6x6 heavy watercolor paper. For the background, I'm going to play with my Distress Oxide sprays and make sure to shake them well before you start. Now all the products that I'm working with today are on great sale since it is Black Friday. For example, all the Ranger products, including these sprays, are 40% off. I have put together a list with all the sales on our favorite online shops and you will find a link to that down below in the description area. So now I'm playing with my sprays, as you can see, inside the box just to keep all that ink contained. And I'm working with three colors here. These are tumbled glass, faded jeans and ice spruce. Now I don't know if you noticed, but the first layer was just water. I wanted to have my paper quite wet so that I help all those inks blend even better. I really don't care on how that first layer is going to look, I'm just going to dry it out and then continue with more layers on top. Again, I'm using the same three Distress Oxide sprays, I'm not introducing any new color. And of course I'm going to use my heat gun again. This is a heat gun, but it has two settings, so it melts embossing powder on one setting and on the other it actually dries things out, so that's why I'm using it here. Now I absolutely love how my background looks at the moment, quick and easy to do, and now I will move on to more fun techniques for creating visual texture. Now I'm going to do some inking. This is a technique that I always like to do on my pages. I like to have darker edges since I find that it helps to bring the eye at the center of my page. It also creates a lovely border, a lovely frame. And I'm working with faded jeans, which is one of the colors that I used for the background, and I'm also going to introduce black soot just to darken up things even more. So here I'm working with one of the new stencils from the Christmas collection by Tim Holtz. I place it on top of my page and I'm going mainly at the edges, all around, making sure that I don't go over the center since I want to have a lighter area there. Now I'm going to lay on top the stencil again, and this time I'm going to go over it and do the same thing with black soot this time. I'm making sure that I don't go as further in as I did with the blue ink. So I'm creating kind of a frame all around. And I will do the same thing with my blending tool towards the edge without using a stencil. Now remember that although everything looks quite vibrant at the moment, this is Distress Oxide ink which fades out as it dries, so you will see at the end it's not going to look as vibrant as it is now. Now another go-to technique to add more interest on the background is to do some stamping. For this page I decided to go with some sentiments from this stamp set. This is an older stamp set from a previous collection by Tim Holtz. It is the Scribble Woodland, but you can use any stamp with holiday sentiments that you have. I'm just going to use black ink and stamp in different areas at the background, as you can see here. This makes it look more interesting, but it's not busy. Another fun technique that you can do with Distress Oxide sprays is to add some water. This is clean water. I'm going to let it react with the ink underneath for a few seconds and then blot it. The more time I let the water react with the ink underneath, the more ink I'm able to lift with my paper. So that's why I'm working quite quickly, since I don't want to have white spots there. Now I am quite happy with how my background looks at the moment. I will leave it aside to completely dry and I will work on my focal point. Now for the focal point I decided to go with the C6 die and I'm going to cut it out of craft cardstock just to get a basic color in the beginning. Of course you can start with white cardstock and color it completely later on. Now I'm going to do some inking over my reindeer. For that I'm using Distress Oxide inks. The color I'm using here is Vintage Photo and the darker one that I will bring in for the shadows is Ground Espresso. So I'm going to do his antlers with that. I'm going to use it to add some shadows underneath his belly and around the edges of the die cut. And I'm also going to do his toes. And of course, for this step, you can use pattern paper if you like to die cut the reindeer. You can also use your acrylic paints to color it in. Just use whatever you have, your watercolors, anything works. Now I'm going to talk a little bit about how you can seal those distress oxides. So I will show you two different methods. Both of them work beautifully. The first one is to cover up your area with matte medium. So this is a completely dry brush. Do not dip it in water. This is very important because water reacts with distress ink. It's going to move it, it's going to smudge it, and you will lose all those beautiful details and shadows that you have been working on. So I'm very lightly applying matte medium over my reindeer. This is going to give him kind of a satin finish when it dries. It's not going to be glossy at all. And he's going to be permanent without reacting with any medium that you decide to put on top. Always remember to put the brush in water. This is going to prevent the bristles from sticking with that matte medium. I always dip everything in water, and when I finish working on my project, I can then go to the sink and wash everything properly. Now another thing that you can use to seal down distress oxides is distress microglaze. This is a product that you can apply with your finger or with a blending tool. I'm just using a very tiny blending tool here by Nuvo that fits inside, but the regular blending tools by Ranger fit as well. So just use anything that works for you. I'm going to get a good amount. I'm going to work it out in the sponge, making sure that it is nice and wet. And then I'm going to apply it all over my background. Now by sealing down my background, I make sure that no matter what I do on top of it, it's not going to move, smudge, or react with the background. So for example, if I do some white splashes over it, the splashes are going to stay white. They are not going to react with the distress oxide spray that it is underneath. Also, another example, if I apply embossing paste, white embossing paste, it's not going to react with the ink underneath and turn into blue. And you can see I can even go over it with my fingers. I can feel the product this way and I can make sure that I have applied it all over the place. I'm also using a clean paper towel just to buff off the excess, and I'm ready to go. Now this is where I decided that I wanted to add some extra shadows on my reindeer. It's a technique that I go back to again and again. I absolutely love it. I'm using here my big brush marker. This is a product by Faber-Castell, and it comes also with a big nib as well as in a smaller nib. The marker that I'm using is Indian Red. I am applying my shadows. I am smudging it with my finger. And although it doesn't dry super quickly, so I have a window of smudging there, once it dries, it's going to be completely permanent. Now I'm going to bring in a darker shade of brown, and this is walnut brown, I believe. And I'm going to add some shadows on his antlers as well as on his toes. Now, if you are not familiar with this technique, which I have shown many times in my videos, just make sure that you work over matte medium or a non-porous surface that allows me to smudge my ink around. Also, make sure that your matte medium underneath is completely dry, otherwise you will ruin your markers, which is not something that you want to do. So I'm going to leave him aside and do some more fun techniques on my background. So here I have some white paint. This is acrylic paint, and I'm applying it with a very thin brush all over the background to add some white splashes. These splashes are going to stay completely white. These splashes are not going to react with the ink underneath and turn into blue. They are going to stay nice and bright just because I have the microglaze underneath. Now I'm going to use my heat gun, make sure that all the splashes are completely dry so that I can move on and do some stenciling. Now again I'm using my stars stencil, again by Tim Holtz. I used it in the previous art journal and I'm using it again. I absolutely love the stencil. I'm going over it all around the edges of my page, and I'm just applying some paste there. This is white paste by Altenew. You can use modeling paste or anything that you have, or you can even use glitter paste if you want to add some sparkle. I let the paste to completely dry, and now I'm ready to start sticking things down. I used foam tape at the back of my reindeer just to have a little bit of dimension. I'm going to stick him down, and I'm going to talk a little bit about that sticking down thing over microglaze in a bit. For now, I'm going to add a dot of glue on his nose, and this is where I decided that I want to turn him into Rudolph. So I used some glitter cardstock and cut out a tiny little dot. And of course you can use glitter paste for that, or your Nouveau Drops, or your Stickles, whatever you have. And now I have Rudolph up in the sky. I'm using a black marker and creating a little dot, so my reindeer has an eye now. Now having microglaze at the background makes things quite difficult when it comes to sticking down, so since I had foam tape there, it didn't stick quite nicely, so I removed the reindeer, I added white glue over my foam tape and put it back on. Now I'm sure that it's not going to fall. Now to make my page more interesting, I'm going to create a little cluster of elements. For that I'm using stickers from the Christmas sticker book. I'm going to pick up a couple of them, just place them one on top of the other, playing around trying to decide what looks good. And again, having microglaze underneath, you see I can easily lift it, so just to make sure that I'm not going to lose my element, I added a piece of cardboard at the back for some dimension and glue, and now I'm sure that this is going to stay put. I also picked one more sticker from the sticker book just to bring more red into my page. And you can leave it as it is, or you can embellish it even more, like I'm going to do now. I always have fun when I'm creating my art journal pages, so I can go on and on adding even more details. So here I used a die by Sizzix, and this is called Large Funky Festive. I used one die from the set to cut out these three leaves, and now I'm going over them with white gesso, but you can use acrylic paint if you like. I'm just dabbing the color in different areas. I don't want to cover up completely the craft cardstock, but I want to have the look of snow. Now I'm going to use my scissors to cut all those leaves into pieces, since they are quite big for my page as they are. And then I'm going to tuck them underneath the stickers, on the top and at the bottom. And notice that I didn't cut them out of green. I don't have any green on my page and I don't want to introduce any new colors. That's why I went completely neutral with these leaves. So I'm using my Nouveau Deluxe glue to stick everything down. And I'm going to bring one more element. This is a metal token from the Christmas collection. I'm going to pick one of them. This one has holiday magic engraved on top of it. So I'm going over it with gesso, making sure that gesso goes inside that engraving. Now I'm going to pick up some baby wipe and clean up the top, but gesso remains in the nooks and crannies of the engraved sentiment, so you can easily read it now. I'm going to thread some twine and place it with some foam squares at the back. And over the foam square I do add white glue, just to make sure that this is going to stay put. Again, I have microglaze at the back, nothing sticks easily there. I have three pieces of twine here, all in three different colors, but neutral colors. I'm going to tie a knot, and this is going to look as if it is scarf. Now, if you love details, another thing that you can do here is to add a tiny little bell on his neck. I didn't have a mini one, all the ones that I had were too big for his neck, so I'm just going to leave it as it is. Okay, now I'm going to do the final step. I'm going to add a few gems here and there, not too many, since I don't want to make it too busy. And after that step, I convinced myself that I have to call this page done. As always, down below you will find a list of all the products that I used for this project, and you will also find a link to the blog post where I have put together the Black Friday list of deals. Make sure to shop around, I'm sure you will find the products that you want in great prices. So that's my project for today, and I am going to frame it and decorate my house. And don't forget that this idea would work on a canvas, would work on a book journal, take the idea and make it your own. So I hope you had fun, that you got inspired. Don't forget to leave me a comment, to like and subscribe if you haven't done so already. Thank you all so much for joining me today, and I'll see you all next time.